Hi, my name is Alan Yu, a program manager on the SQL Server team. In today's how-to video, I will be covering our notebook viewer in Azure Data Studio, creating your first SQL notebook, and how to interact with and use your SQL notebook. Notebooks are single documents that comprise of rich text cells like Markdown and executable code cells like Python. Notebooks can also include visualizations, code output, and even GIFs. Notebooks are a very popular tool in the data scientist community for use cases such as interactive tutorials, running daily analysis, or telling stories using data models. Azure Data Studio supports notebooks, including a special kernel known as the SQL kernel. With the SQL kernel, you can now create custom notebooks using both T-SQL or PostgreSQL. Let's start off with our SQL notebook toolbar. As you can see, you could easily add a code cell or a text cell and then quickly be able to write things and see the preview of it. And then you can also delete your cell. As mentioned before, we have the special SQL kernel used in this notebook, but you could also easily change it if you wanted to have a Python notebook or a Spark notebook, etc. Next, you see this component called attach to, and this is where you actually make a connection to your SQL Server instance where your notebook will be run against. So for now, I'm running a version of SQL Server 2017 locally. Next, we're able to make sure that our notebook is trusted, have the ability to run all the code cells of a notebook, and then also be able to clear all the output from those code cells easily from a click of a button. So for the purposes of this tutorial, we'll be looking at this tutorial from our official SQL Server docs, where you can create and query database objects and essentially learn how to write T-SQL. This is a very important use case of notebooks where you can help educate people of how to get started on your team or just generally learn about SQL itself. So what we're gonna do here is essentially copy over this tutorial, which I have here in Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to copy over the text component, which is written in Markdown, and I'm going to add a text cell. So as you can see here, several things appear. So to start off, Markdown is a rich text language for converting text to HTML. There are many resources online to learn more about Markdown, but for now, I'll show some of the components of a text cell. So for example, one of the components of Markdown is that if you add a pound sign, this indicates that it's a header. And you can see that there's a preview as you type here. And it will automatically show the information below. So it's easily, you can tell what is the output of your Markdown. So after you're comfortable with providing the instructions at the top of your notebook, you can next add a code cell by clicking this button here or on the toolbar as mentioned before. So I'm gonna add a code cell, and essentially this will run a T-SQL command for creating your database. And then if I want to execute this cell right now, I could click the play button to run the cell. So I could continue this process of combination of text cells and adding code cells on a repeated pattern, but to save all of us time, I already created this notebook before, and we can now use this to explore what exactly this tutorial includes. So you can see that it starts off by creating a table, teaching the creating a database, and this tells you how to get started with creating a database, and then it will eventually go down to inserting actual data into your table, and then eventually being able to select that values as well. So for this notebook, it actually is okay that we already run all the cells at once, so then we could go around and play with the tutorial itself. So in order to execute all the code cells, you could click Run Cells here, and then the notebook will just start running all the code cells and generate output for it. So for example, you see there's a select statement here, and you can see that the output is nicely printed out from our results grid. And in fact, if you wanted to share this data in another format, you could right-click on it and then save it in these very common formats, such as a CSV. Then we'll save it really quick here. And you can see that you'll be able to save your results on a CSV file or for the other supported file types. So in addition, if you wanted to rerun this cell to make sure that any changes to the database occurred, you can rerun it and you can confirm that all the data still is the same. So there's a lot of use cases that you could do with creating your own SQL notebooks. Not only can you be using this to help educate people and have a step-by-step process as they walk through the tutorial, but you can also imagine using this for running daily jobs and just have all the basic configuration in there, and then include markdown instructions so that you can easily understand when to execute these different pieces of T-SQL. So there's a lot of fun things you can do with notebooks, and this will just help you get started with creating your very first one. So in order to help you get started with creating SQL notebooks after this video, I've created these awesome next steps for you. You could first start off by downloading Azure Data Studio at ak.ms/get-azure-data-studio. You could also visit our docs, where you have specific documentation explaining a lot of the concepts that I talked about in this video. And then follow us on Twitter for any of the latest updates as we continue to grow this feature and notebook itself. Please try out SQL Notebooks today. Thank you.